they officially told me yesterday.
Kyle, where do you feel like you've grown most this season?
There's a lot. I'd say I told you guys a lot. Just command, just knowing the pitcher I am, get better every outing, and knowing what works for me.
Kyle, is there a start that stands out to you most this year that, you know, maybe it didn't go the way you wanted and you took something away from that that has helped you get to this point?
I'd say kind of the turning point was my outing in San Francisco. Had a rough inning, and then got taken out of the fourth, and then kind of there just had a little mindset shift, just knowing that I can't keep doing that. It's hurting the bullpen, hurting the team, so just going out there, working for a quality start every time was kind of the mindset after that one.
Kyle, as you've been preparing, what stands out to you about Texas, a team that you guys haven't faced in a couple months now?
Yeah, I mean, I've watched them on TV a lot. They've got really good players, really good offense. So it'll be a fun series, but faced them a couple times this year and last year, so I'm familiar with most of their guys. But, yeah, just, I mean, really good offense.
On your right, Kyle, with Gabe.
Hey, Kyle. When you talk about growth, what to you was the bigger year where you had a greater rate of growth? Was it 2022 when you really got your feet down in a big league rotation, or was it this year when you got deeper into games, started to see the seventh inning, and now you're starting game one of a playoff game?
Yeah, good question. I'd say last year was kind of the bigger step for me. My first 10 starts didn't go the way I wanted them to, and then ended up on the injury list for about a month. And then came back, and the second half was kind of just complete opposite of what the first half was. And I think that gave me the confidence to go into the off season and then just work, know what I can do and have that success and just keep working for that.
Far back on the right center aisle, Kyle.
Hey, Kyle. When you think about what this ballpark is going to be like when you take the mound tomorrow, the noise level, the intensity, the energy, what's the biggest thing for you to kind of control your emotions and pitch to the best of your ability?
Yeah, I mean, it's going to be a blast having 45,000+ Camden Yards fold up. Going to be really excited. But I think it's the same game that I've been playing. I've played in big stadiums that are full and loud. Just got to embrace it. All these people are here to watch us and have fun, so why not do the same?
I'm right up front on your right, Kyle.
Kind of a follow-up to that. Your teammates say how even keel you are, especially on the mound. How much do you think it's going to help you tomorrow, and how much do you think that that's helped you all season?
Yeah, I just try not to let one thing affect me too much. It's kind of what I've been taught my whole career is just take it one pitch at a time. Don't let the last one affect the next one. So just got to go out there, trust my stuff, trust my defense, and just know that we've been doing this all year. Keep it rolling.
In the third row on your right.
Kyle, you mentioned, you know, your first 10 starts last year. Grayson went through kind of a similar thing this season. Is that something you and him have talked about at all?
We talked a little bit when he was struggling and then ended up going down. I talked a little bit while he was down, and then when he came back up, just told him what I was told, just, hey, this is an opportunity to go clear your mind and get back to what you've done to get you here. So, I mean, hats off to him for running with that, and he's been so great for this team this second half since he's came up.
In the second row on your far left, Kyle.
Kyle, you and the rest of the starters have taken big leaps this year. What did these playoffs represent to you as an opportunity to show maybe the wider baseball world what's been happening here?
I mean, I think it's just another way for us to showcase our talents. I know there's a lot of talk that our pitching staff, particularly the starting pitchers, kind of haven't been the strong suit to this team. So I think it's another opportunity to show what we are actually capable of.
We'll stay in the same row.
Kyle, the Ranger starters obviously did really well in the wild card series against the Rays. How important is it for you as a starter to go out there, set the tone when you're matched up against them on the mound?
Yeah, I think it's important to go out there any game and set the tone as a starting pitcher. Especially being home, you're going to be the first guy out there to start it. So just going out there, set the tone, and just let our guys know that we're here.
Same row right in the middle.
Kyle, you guys were one of the surprise teams in the league last year. It's never a guarantee that next year you'll be able to be even better. What has allowed you guys as a team to put yourself in the position that you're in now, where you're the one seed in the American League?
I think the biggest thing is we're all friends, kind of having that bond in the clubhouse, the culture that Hyde and everybody else is kind of created, and then just the talent that we have on this team through the free agents that we brought in to the younger guys that have came up. I think you see a kind of complete team that are actually pull for each other no matter what.
We'll stay right there.
Kyle, have the combined quality of your breaking balls been the best in your time in the pros, you know, right now, are they? And what makes them that?
Yeah, I'd say this kind of whole season, after that first month where we kind of started relying on those heavier, they've kind of grown as well as have I as a pitcher, and they just play off each other. They're both hard, but slider goes one direction, and curveball is pretty 12-6. So being able to throw those around the same velo, I think, helps keep hitters kind of off balance.
Left center aisle, far back.
Kyle, is it kind of surreal to be starting game one, your second season in the show? And what does it mean to you to have the trust of Brandon Hyde and the club to be out there and be that game one starter?
Yeah, I mean, it's an honor to start this first playoff game. I want to say thanks to Hyde and everybody else. But, you know, this is what I expect out of myself. So I'm just really looking forward to it.
Second row on your right, Kyle.
Kyle, Brandon talked about the calmness in the locker room being very loose today as you get started for the series. How do you keep that level throughout this time against the Rangers?
I think just keep doing what we've been doing all year. We don't let that many things affect us. I think we're a pretty even keel as a whole team. So just keep going about our business and doing what we've been doing to get us here.
Anything else for Kyle? All right, Kyle, congratulations. And.